GNAT Project Manager, Part 12, Programming Scenario Number 1. In this scenario, we will modify the body of a package in the release. We start by selecting a module or a component from the drop-down list in the scenario view that contains a package we want to modify. In this case, Module A, Component A01, contains a package. With the component loaded into GPS, we can immediately see the dependencies in the project view. For example, in Module A, Component A01 is seen to depend on Component A03 and no others, which agrees with the dependency diagram shown earlier. We can also see at a glance that there are no compilation dependencies between modules, since modules B and C are untouched. In order to make a code change, we need to add the unit of interest to the extending project, that is, the workspace, where it can be checked out of version control and opened in the editor. By clicking Do Not Copy, we communicate our desire to work with a versioned unit on drive E and not with a copy on drive W. Note that until the first unit is transferred to the workspace, the root of drive W is the only option available to the copy command. After the Do Not Copy button is pressed, the workspace directory is displayed and the selected unit is transferred from the release directory to the corresponding version control directory. As you can see, the unit is no longer visible in the release. Because the release on drive R is read-only, the file is, of course, physically still there. It is just hidden from the project manager as a result of the entry component A01 ADB in the source files attribute of the workspace project. Once the unit is on drive V, it is checked out of version control and we can modify its contents. After making a small change in compiling, a look in the build directory of the workspace shows that only the unit that we changed has been affected. All the other associated object files required to compile the unit were found and used on the release drive. Hence, the time required to compile changes in the workspace is negligible. A click on the Build Main button invokes the GNAT Make, GNAT Bind, and GNAT Link processes to produce the executable compa01.exe. You might recall that the release project uses the attribute executable to produce an image with a specified name. Without this attribute, the name of the image would be the name of the unit, that is, component underscore a01.exe. Because we are working at the component level, where only essential units are present, a complex problem has been reduced to a simple problem, which is relatively easy to understand, modify, and test. Each incremental release contains a static analysis report of the entire subsystem. The report is produced by CodePeer and can be viewed in a browser as shown here. You should always consult this report as a first step towards solving a problem, as this information can save you a lot of time. Here is the entry page of the same static analysis report, but displayed within GPS. A static analysis of an entire subsystem normally requires several hours of computing time on a powerful build server. Therefore, do not attempt to analyze a complete subsystem on your development PC, which is probably a laptop computer. Instead, only work with components when using CodePeer. If the component you wish to analyze is very small, for example, 1,000 source lines of code or less, then use the Analyze All command. Otherwise, use Analyze File. To determine the number of source lines of code in a component, use the metrics tool in GPS. We now transfer a second unit to the workspace. This time, we are presented with a list of directories for the copy command. The first directory in the list is the root of drive V. The only purpose of this directory is to allow modification of the subprogram allmainunits.adb. The second directory, source, at the root of the workspace is normally used to hold a copy of sources that exist on drive R and or drive V. A unit copy to source is often the target of an experiment or refactoring. The original unit on drive R and or drive V is then hidden from the compilation system. The remaining directories and their contents on drive V are under version control. So, proceeding as before, we click the Do Not Copy button since we want to work with the unit under version control. At this point, we have transferred a third unit from the release to the workspace, compiled all the sources, and used CodePeer to analyze the workspace. In doing so, we have exposed a range check issue. In a real project, this would be investigated and corrected immediately. This is the end of part 12.